5:33 is now the time. It is not every day we get to see a glowing red moon. Tonight, the moon, sun, and Earth will align to create a rare lunar eclipse that can be seen across America. Here to tell us more is NASA expert Ernie Wright, who is joining us live. Ernie, good morning. Thank you so much for taking the time to join us. Not very often this happens.
That's right. Good morning, and thanks for having me. There's a lunar eclipse every couple of years, but this one we are perfectly situated to see. The entire United States will see the entire lunar eclipse tonight.
And tell us a little bit about the redness. Why is this moon going to be red?
Well, it's actually all of the sunrises and sunsets across the Earth being projected onto the face of the moon. So all of those beautiful oranges and reds are the same ones that you see when the sun is rising or setting.
Very good. Now, how can our viewers see the eclipse? I mean, obviously, weather permitting is one, but can you give us some more details? This is such an exciting time, you know, if folks can step outside.
Yeah, I was so surprised to see that it's raining so much in San Diego. But weather permitting, the eclipse is going to last for several hours. The partial phase is going to start a little bit after 10 p.m. Pacific time. And by 11:30, the moon will be completely covered. You have about an hour to watch that total phase. So even if it's cloudy for some part of that time, it might be worth getting up and just waiting for a break in the clouds so you can see that beautiful orange-red moon. To me, it looks almost transparent, like it's trying to disappear like the Cheshire Cat.
Oh, wow.
So it's a pretty amazing looking thing, and any opportunity you have to see one of these is worth it.
Now, do we need any special equipment, any special eyewear to see it, or is it just, you can see it by the naked eye?
Naked eye, that's one of the lovely things about a lunar eclipse. You don't need solar eclipse glasses. It's perfectly safe to look at with your eyes. You don't need a telescope, but if you happen to have a telescope or binoculars, those will enhance your view. All you need to do is go outside, cross your fingers for a break in the clouds, and look to the south or the southwest, and find the moon.
Very cool. You know, Ernie, since we have you here live via satellite, if you will, can I ask you about this? You know, NASA has a mission that's orbiting the moon right now. That's definitely, it's taking all these detailed images, coming back with all this data, and it's been doing that for many, many years. What have we learned from all of this data and these images so far that you can share with us?
So Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, or LRO, has been in orbit around the moon for 16 years, and it's building global maps of the color, and we use the color to decide what the surface is composed of, and also the shape, and that's what gives you those dramatic shadows on the craters. We're learning that the moon is a living place. It's not just a dead rock. There's a lot of things going on there, and LRO is also preparing us for future human missions to the moon. And that's really exciting because we have found water there. We have found other resources there. It's a great front porch for our exploration of the solar system. And the other great thing about the moon is that it remembers everything. Unlike the Earth, where all the early history of the solar system has been erased by weather and tectonics and all kinds of things, the moon remembers all of that. So learning about the moon is learning about where the Earth came from and our solar system came from.
This is such an exciting time to be studying the moon. What are you most excited for in this new era, if you will, of lunar exploration?
Well, what I love is working with the scientists. I don't have a geology background, but I work with the geologists that study the moon, and I get to learn from them exactly what we're learning from LRO and the other missions that are going to the moon. I get to share in their excitement about what they're learning. And so that's kind of the favorite part of my job, is to interact with the scientists and find out everything that we're finding out about the moon.
You have a very cool job, Ernie. Before I let you go, real quick, where can our viewers learn more about our moon and also just some more detailed information on how to view tonight's eclipse?
People can go to science.nasa.gov/moon. There's an article there specifically about this eclipse where you can learn more details about the timing and what you'll see. But there are also lots of other resources for observing and learning about the moon.
Awesome. All right. 10 p.m. is when the partial eclipse starts. And then from there, 11 o'clock-ish is the time to really be looking up. Weather permitting, hopefully,
That's
Ernie,
right.
Our fingers are crossed. Thank you so much,
right.
Ernie Wright, NASA expert, for taking the time. Great to talk to you.